Hello friend, if you have ever googled the term best Linux distro, you have probably been hit with a flood of options. Ubuntu, Fedora, Arch, Mint, PopOS, and the list goes on. But why there are so many distros? Why it is so complicated? That is because unlike Windows or Mac operating system, Linux does not have one default version. There are literally hundreds of Linux distributions, each designed with a unique purpose. Some are beginner friendly like Ubuntu and Linux Mint. Others like Arch and Gentoo caters to power users who want complete control. Then there are distros for privacy, gaming, lightweight system and so on. It is no wonder that many users feel lost, and while this option to choose is empowering, for beginners it can be overwhelming. Along with that, if you ask someone for advice, they might reply with, just install Arch or go with Fedora or Ubuntu. But the problem is, what works for them might not work for you. Everyone's need, hardware, and experience level is different. So to help you with this issue, I will tell you about two amazing websites that are designed to simplify your distro search. These tools help you to narrow down options based on your personal preferences, ensuring you find the perfect Linux distro tailored to your needs. So let's dive in and discover the ideal Linux distro for you. Our first website is librehunt.org, a sleek and beginner-friendly website created by Indian Linux enthusiast Avi Vadhwa. According to Avi's own word, one day his schoolmate saw his fancy Linux install on his laptop and asked how did he get it. So Avi, after explaining to his friend what Linux is, his friend immediately wanted it as well. But he got stuck in deciding which distro to start with, as there are too many options. This incident gave Avi an idea to create this website to make it easier for beginners as well as advanced users to have an easy method to search their Linux distro. So how does LibreHunt do this magic? LibreHunt attempts to help users to choose a Linux distribution according to their needs based on answers given by the users to various objective type questions. Now let us see how you can use LibreHunt. So when you first land on LibreHunt homepage, you will be greeted with a basic information about what is an operating system, how Linux is different from other operating systems, and why you should choose Linux over Windows or Mac operating system, and some additional information about the main characteristics of Linux, such as security and privacy, its lightweight nature, openness, and awesome customization options. Finally, at the bottom, we have the tool which we are going to use to find our perfect Linux distro. This test contains 11 questions in total, ranging from topics like use case, Linux expertise, hardware architecture, support, method of installation, software and operating system updates, etc. And as per LibreHunt, you can always skip the questions and change the answers at any time. And after you have answered the questions, LibreHunt algorithm will suggest you few options from their curated list of 45 distros. So without further ado, let's give it a try. So the first question we have is about Linux expertise. How good are you with computers and Linux? In my case, I would say medium. Next, old hardware support. Do you need to run your distro on older hardware? No, therefore it does not matter. Next, hardware architecture. What type of processor does your computer run on? 64-bit. Next, timely updates. Do you want apps like update, as in updates as they come, or OS like updates as once in 6 months? Okay, you will find a lot of Linux users who prefer rolling release or fast updating distros, resulting them going with Arch or Fedora. And there is nothing wrong with that, if they know what they are doing. In my case, till now after using or daily driving Linux for maybe 4 years, I still prefer stable updates, and that is why I use Debian Stable in my main system. So here I will go with usual. Next, Gaming. Do you want the distro to have a focus on delivering a good gaming experience, or it does not matter? Well, I do play some video games, but I am not a hardcore gamer, so it does not matter. Next question. Lookalike. Do you want the distro to look something like Mac operating system or Windows, or it does not matter? So what you can do here is you can choose if you want a Windows-like interface or a macOS-like interface. But as I do not need any one of them, so I will select none. Next, touch support. Do you have a touchscreen? No, therefore does not matter. Next, popularity and support. Would you want to use a distro with more popularity and support than something small and different? So here is an important thing to note. Popular distros like Ubuntu, Mint, Fedora or Arch has large communities and therefore have extensive documentation and forums available online, which is very useful in times of troubleshooting complicated issues. Therefore, it is better to go with a popular distro if you are new to Linux. So I would select yes. Okay, next. Appearance. Would you want an unique experience and appearance the second you install it than something with a typical stock appearance or desktop? For me, it does not matter. Next, we have free software. Do you want to stick to just free drivers and codecs, or it does not matter? So, here I do want to select free software only, but remember, if you are someone who uses NVIDIA GPU, then you will need proprietary drivers for better performance. But for now, I will select the does not matter option. Okay, final question. Method of installing packages. Would you want to use pre-made binary software packages or have everything compiled from source code? No doubt, I want to use the binary packages because I do not want too much hassle. And as far as I know, only Gentoo offers you the option to compile everything from the source code, and it is not known as a beginner-friendly distro. So that's it. Our test is complete, so let's submit and see the results. So the first three options we have are Elementary OS, Linux Mint and Ubuntu. All of them are excellent choice for beginners. Elementary and Mint are both based on Ubuntu, and Ubuntu itself is based on Debian. No doubt, great options for new users. Next, we have Zorin OS, Fedora, and Debian at number 456. Again, great choice for beginners. Zorin OS is a good option to anyone switching from Windows. And Fedora is a favorite choice of Linus Torvald, the creator of Linux kernel. So definitely anyone can use it. And what can I say about Debian? It is my personal favorite. And if not all, then most of the Linux distros trace their roots to Debian. Okay, then we have Pop, Kubuntu, Zubuntu, Ubuntu Budgy, Ubuntu Mate, MX Linux, all are from the Debian Ubuntu family. Then Solus, again a very stable independent distro and also the creator of Budgy desktop environment. Next we have Endless OS, Pure OS and Trisquel. I don't know much about them because I have never used them. Then we have OpenSUSE Lib, great distro but maybe not great for beginners. Deepin, maybe okay, beautiful looking distro, but I do not recommend it. Last we have Manjaro, a beginner friendly distro from Arch branch, and finally Mojia Gnome. So great option for any Linux user, and I will highly recommend the first 12 option to any beginner as they are great starting points. So that is LibreHunt for you. Give it a try and I am pretty sure that you will find your perfect Linux match. Now let's move on to our second website, which is distrochooser.de. DistroChooser was created by German programmer named Christoph Müller. And as the name suggests, the goal of DistroChooser is the same as LibreHunt. But where it differs is it takes a more refined approach to finding your ideal Linux distro. DistroChooser drills down into more details, allowing for multiple answers. Let's check out how you can find the ideal Linux distro using DistroChooser. So the homepage is very simple. There is a menu on the left side which contains the question section, and there are total 13 questions ranging from use case, computer knowledge, knowledge of Linux, OS install preset, hardware and software support, user experience, privacy, price, and all sorts of things. In the mid section, you have your instructions, which says you can always skip questions. You can always change or delete answers at any time. You can receive additional information using the question mark icon, and you can star mark your answers, giving it more weightage or importance. And finally, you can always click to the show your results option to end the test and get your personalized recommendation. So let's cut the fuss and try this test and see how it works. So the first question is, some distributions are made for a special purpose, some for daily use. What do you need? I definitely want to use it daily. Right now, I am not interested in anonymous web browsing or gaming, nor I want to execute all my programs in an isolated area. I am not visually impaired. And yes, I want to install it on physical hardware. So here, I will only choose the first option and also star mark it because it is a very important point to me. Next, how would you rate your proficiency using a computer? Often need help from others to fix problems with my computer? No. Already able to solve some computer problems by myself? Yes. Troubleshoot most or all computer problems by myself? Yes, I do. Okay, now I'm confused. Which one should I choose? Okay, I will go with the second one because I think I am good with Linux but not an expert. So second one. Proceed next. How would you rate your knowledge of Linux itself? Little or no knowledge? Already use Linux? Have good understanding about Linux? I will go with the second one, already use Linux. Next. How many settings do you wish to tweak by yourself during installation? How many configuration variables should be filled with default values? Okay, the options are: use the default preset value in the installation assistant, choose the setting by myself, configure as much as possible using graphical application. Here I would like to go with the default. Next, it is important to know how old your computer hardware is, since some distribution won't run on old computers. No issue, my hardware does support 64-bit. Next, some distribution prefer articles in wikis for troubleshooting. What do you prefer? Options are: solve my problems using guides from wiki pages and tutorials, or prefer asking help from others. No worries, I am able to solve my problems. Next, Linux can use a lot of different user interface or desktops. Many distributions ship one desktop as default. Okay, I get the point. It is about the Windows-like interface or Mac-like interface. So as I need none of them, so I will skip this question. Next, most Linux distributions are free. Some distributions offer additional support for one-time fee. So as I am very poor, therefore I prefer a free-to-use distribution, no doubt. Okay, next. Different distributions pre-install different amount of software. Some install a complete suite of basic programs to work out of the box. Other distributions offer only base install to then let users install what program they want to use. I do not want a bloated system, so I will go with the second. I myself will install the basic programs. Okay, next. The license ideology of the distribution is a contentious debate. There are distributions using mostly free licenses. Others also use non-free license or non-free software. No doubt, I want to use the free license as much as I can. In fact, I think most people who use Linux is because of this, isn't it? Next question. Some distributions use online services to improve the user experience. This may affect the privacy of the user. No, I do not want to be tracked. This is the one of many reasons why I left Windows, so I do not want this. Next, there are many ways to administrate a Linux distribution, example to install software. I want to install my programs using a kind of app store. Yes, that would be great. I want to install mostly using terminal commands. I have no problem using CLI, so I will select that as well. I want to avoid system D. Actually, I do not care much about init system. So I will only select the first two options. Okay, the final question. Some distributions offer faster updates, which can affect system stability. What do you prefer? I prefer stable updates all the time. That's it. So now let's check our results. Well, just look at the first result. It's Debian. Nice. Next we have Dev1. It is basically Debian without systemd. In the third and fourth option, we have Rocky Linux, which is based on Red Hat, or you can say Fedora, and OpenSUSE. Both of them are great distros, but not good for beginners. Next, we have MX Linux and Fedora. No doubt, great options, definitely recommended. Then we have Arch and Gentoo. Okay, maybe they are the two of the best Linux distro out there, but they are never recommended for beginners. Then we have Artix and Crux Linux, again not recommended for beginners. Then we have Qebs or KubeSwiss, great choice if you prefer the highest level of security and privacy. Then Nopix, Red Hat, Wired Linux, NixOS, not recommended for beginners. Then we have Zorin, Linux Mint, Manjaro, Elementary, Kubuntu, Solus, Ubuntu, Zubuntu, Ubuntu Mate, Pop, Lubuntu. No doubt, all of them are great choice for beginners. Deepin, beautiful desktop environment, but it always seems bloated to me. PC Linux OS, can't say much about it because I have never used it. And finally, Tails. Same as Qebs OS. Nice option if you prefer the highest level of security and privacy. But you have to run it from a live USB and it cannot be installed on a physical hardware. That's it. So I think the results are very interesting at Distro Chooser because it started with some good options for beginners, but then recommended some that are good for advanced users and again continued with various beginner friendly options. So I have a mixed feeling about Distro Chooser. So now, if you ask me which one is better, then in my opinion, if you are completely new to the world of free and open source and Linux, then LibreHunt would be the best option. Because it is dead simple and easy to use, and in my testing, I think the answers were more organized than what I got from DistroChooser. But on the other hand, the benefit of DistroChooser is that it lets you really dial into the specific requirements and needs. Therefore, it would be better for those who have a moderate knowledge of computer and operating systems. But in the end, I will encourage you to try both of them because if you find one or two common distro recommendations in both the sites, then you have probably struck gold and that's a good place to begin. But again, I will also remind you that the beauty of Linux is that you are not logged in. You do not have to fit a mold or adapt to an operating system you are using. Linux can adapt to you, whether that right out of the box or by your own hand. And I am pretty confident you will find a satisfying and comfortable distro by using these two awesome tools. Thanks for watching. If you have liked this video, please subscribe to the channel because your support encourages us to create videos of this kind. See you next time. Until then, have fun and enjoy your Linux journey.